Hello and welcome to a video about how we get data from our ESP32 now to an MQTT server. This is our next step. Last video in this series, we tried to read in the rotary encoder. It in the end worked for whatever reason. And now we want to get this data into MQTT server. First step is to connect to your Wi-Fi. Alright, so we need to add some things here. I will save this as, what would be a nice name? 33 ESP connect Wi-Fi. Now connect MQTT. I'll write it like that. Connect MQTT. This is the program we used last time. So first step is to connect to Wi-Fi. So we'll add simply some string variables where I give in the data. You will not see this data. You should know it. Alright, so SSID and password we need, and then I will make a function which will connect Wi-Fi, let's say, yeah? Okay. I will also use a bool. Connect Wi-Fi. This function I'm going to call. And to use Wi-Fi, I have to include the Wi-Fi library. So I will write here hashtag include Wi-Fi.h. I think this is how it's called. Yes, looks good. Perfect. Looks good. So connect Wi-Fi. Down here, whenever the status of my Wi-Fi, I now can simply use Wi-Fi. Okay. And this I will do here. If Wi-Fi status, this holds the status of the Wi-Fi connection, is not like, and this compile time constant holds the correct number of connected. So if this is not connected, I'm going to call this function. Connect Wi-Fi. Good. In the function I will use a static int I, which I will initialize with 0. And I will say if I equals 0, then I start the connection. Okay? Then I start the connection. I will also use a static unsigned long last connection try. This is the milliseconds when I last tried it. Okay? And I will write here define Wi-Fi con timeout, and I will try it every 2 seconds, I would say. Okay, every 2 seconds. So here I can write if millis minus last con try is longer than this Wi-Fi connection timeout, yeah, I will try to connect with my Wi-Fi. Yeah, and I do this by Wi-Fi dot begin. All right, and I will use this Wi-Fi SSID and the password, and then I will of course set the last contry to the actual milliseconds. Okay, so now it should try to connect. That's what I do. I will also serial.print, I'll print this out. Try to connect to, and I will make serial.println Wi-Fi SSID. That we know to which SSID we are going to connect. Okay, so this and I will add one I. So that we are not running into this, we are going up here, else. Yeah? So if I is not zero, I already tried to connect, yeah? And well, I already tried to connect, and that's it. Yeah? That's it. I know the time when I connected it, yeah. So here I have to check if again this here Wi-Fi status is not like connected. Wi-Fi status is not like connected. Then I will simply say if millis minus last contry bigger than 500, yeah, I will say, so 500 milliseconds afterwards, I will say I plus plus, all right, and I will make a print. I will print the dot. That every 500 milliseconds, if we are not connected, we will make this dot. All right. And if E is bigger than I will also define here a new. Define max Wi-Fi try, yeah, let's say 10. Then we tried it for 5 seconds, should be okay. Is bigger than max forgotten Wi-Fi try. I will make serial.println could not connect. And I will set I to 0. Okay. So if we cannot connect, we will go back up here and this should work, I guess. Else, all right, what's, if we are connected, we are fine. We write serial.print. Line connected, I will set I to 0. I think that's it. Ah, Here we'll also set this last con dry. Equals millis. Then we will get this every 500 milliseconds. So, we're going to connect now. Where is the cable? Here. Bing, bidi, bing. Let's see what's happening. Upload. Ooh. Of course, it's called include. It's called include, not include. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Of course. This is something I also, here we have to use, it is expecting a whole C format string. Okay, it is expecting a C format string, so I am using here C string, the function C string. I'm using this C string object. I know people don't like it very much, this C object, this string object, and often use C strings. And this is why this, there is a C string function of this string object method, which we're returning a C string, C type string, a null terminated string. This is, you can look it up in the internet. Ooh, now it's connecting. Now it's downloading. Yeah. Doing it right, working. Resetting. Let's see. What is the output? Output. It's already connected, what? Try to connect. Is it connected or not? Why is it not printed connected? Because we're not calling it anymore. All right. All right. Then I have to introduce a Boolean Wi-Fi connected false. Okay, I will set this Wi-Fi connected here to true. Also good. And here I do not check the status, I check the Wi-Fi connected. And now we should see it. Now we should see it. Hopefully. Then we are connected to the Wi-Fi. Then we call it a day. If not connected, hands. What's up? Focus. Ford focus. connected. This is how you connect to Wi-Fi, this code, right? And you even have a decent output connected, okay? Next step, I will explain this in the next video. Next step is then to bring this to the MQTT server. I will use Hive NQ, Cloud MQTT server, and push it to the internet then. The data. For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.